Hello dear friends, welcome to today's session on Padhai Se Dosti YouTube channel. So in this particular session we are going to discuss about the location and extent. So now let's discuss some interesting history about these two countries. They have somewhat similar history of colonial era. Okay, so India was under the British rule for almost 1.5 century. India got independence in 1947 despite facing several problems like three wars, like Indo-Pak War in 1948, Indo-China War in 1961-62, India-Pakistan War again in 1965. Okay, then famine situation in various part of India, similar issues after independence. So similar type of issues also faced by Brazil. Okay, so after independence, India is a major developing country of the world. India is considered to be a global market also because Indian population is almost 1.35 billion. Okay, so this is a very huge population and it is one of the major global market in the world also. Because of the various economic reforms from time to time, India's economic development has paced up. Means India grows economically in the world, and in right now India's entire economy in terms of GDP, gross domestic product, we will consider all this economic term in economic geography, don't worry about it. So according to GDP, India's rank in the world is 5. According to purchasing power parity, India is the third largest economy. Remember the numbers only, don't remember the economic term, we will discuss later on. The proportion of youth in Indian population is high. Almost 63%+ of our country is youth population, and that's why it is known as young country, young population country. Okay, because of this, the major part of our population is working population. That's why India looked upon as a young country. Remember this thing. This might be asked in give the geographical reason. Okay, question might be asked like that, give geographical reason why India is known as young country. The somewhat same historical background is there for Brazil also. For more than three centuries, Brazil was under the Portuguese era. Brazil gained its independence in 1822. Okay, so in 19th century, Brazil get independence from Portuguese, and in 20th century, in 1947, more specifically, India get independence from British. Okay, so from 1930 to 1985, more than half century, Brazil is under the populist military government. So there was a military rule, not democracy, for this almost for half century in Brazil from 1930 to 1985. It has overcome global financial difficulties in late 20th century. Brazil is also seen as contributor to the economic growth of the world and important market in the future. Okay, so Brazil, if we consider the Brazil population, then it is the fifth largest in the world. Okay, so show the following elements in the figure 2.3. Name the countries and oceans of the world. Okay, sorry, continents, not countries, continents and the ocean of the world. So here you can able to see the world map over here. So you have to locate the continent and oceans. First of all, let's see the continent. There are total 7 continents, right? So sabse bada jo hai, the biggest continent is the Asia, then second one is Africa, third one is North America, fourth one South America. Okay, then we have Europe, then we have Australia, and here in the southern part we have Antarctica. So these are the 7 continent. The order which I have told you, that is the order according to its area. So the largest one is Asia, second largest Africa, third largest North America continent, fourth largest South America continent, fifth largest is Europe, which is the continent over here. Okay, the sixth one is Australia, and seventh one is Antarctica, which is somewhat here. Okay, so remember this thing. And the water bodies, remember the water bodies. This is Indian Ocean, this is Pacific Ocean, this is Southern Ocean, this is Atlantic Ocean over here, this is Arctic Ocean near the North Pole, this is Pacific Ocean because Earth is rounded shape, you can able to observe over here. So this is Indian Ocean. Okay, this is Pacific Ocean between the Asia and North America. The entire water body is known as Pacific Ocean. Okay, this is Atlantic Ocean, S-shaped body like this, Atlantic Ocean, the northern part. So this entire water body is known as Arctic Ocean. Okay, here southern part, this is Antarctica continent, and the water body near to the Antarctica continent is known as Southern Ocean. Remember this thing. So in this way we have discussed the continents and oceans in the world. The next question is, color the Brazil and India in different colors and name them. Very easy question. Draw the equator on a map and write its value in degrees. You can do on your own. Show the symbols for the direction. So you can able to show the symbol for direction, right? So very basic thing, I'm not going to cover over here. Let's answer some of this question. So what it is exactly, answer the following question with respect to the countries that you have studied. Out of the countries that you have colored, which country is in larger size? Definitely Brazil is larger than India. Brazil is the fifth largest country in the world. Also, its population is also fifth largest. India is seventh largest country by area and its population is second largest. Remember this thing. Which country has the largest latitudinal extent? So easily we can able to answer, it is a Brazil, because if you consider the range of latitudinal extent of Brazil, then it is how much latitudinal? See here, it is a latitude. We have considered which figure over here? It is a 5 degree 15 minutes north to 33 degrees. Okay, 33 degrees 45 minutes south. So 33 in southern hemisphere and 5 in northern hemisphere, almost 38 degree latitudinal extent Brazil have, but India don't have that much latitudinal extent. It have just somewhat around 37 over here minus this 8. So almost it is a 29 degrees, and in Brazil it is almost around 38 degrees. So 11 degrees gap is there. Remember this thing. That's why Brazil's latitudinal extent is more than that of India. How do the location of Brazil and India differs in terms of their position in their respective continents? I have already told you, Brazil is located in the northeastern part of, so here Brazil is located in the northeastern, so this is the entire South America continent, this is a northeastern part, northern also and eastern also, so northeastern part of South America continent, and India is located in the southern part of Asia continent. This entire is Asia. Okay, the entire part is Asia and India is located in the southern part. Okay, how many states do each of the two countries have? So India have 29 state, Brazil have, you can measure from this particular map over here. So I'm not going to measure one by one, you can do this on your own. Okay, draw the flag of the countries in your notebook. Obtain the information regarding the emblems of both the countries. So do comment in the comment section, which is the emblem of Brazil and which is the emblem of India. Use hum raj chinh bhi bolte. So in this way we have completed this particular chapter. So do these questions on your own. If you have any difficulty, do comment. So guys, I hope you understood this particular topic in very well manner. If you have any doubt, do comment. Share this session with your friends so they will get benefited during this coronavirus lockdown period, and they will remain in touch with their syllabus. Okay, so do share this session with your friends, do subscribe this channel so you will get the more and more interactive session related to your academics. So have a nice day guys. Thank you.